Ryan and I are at Biscayne National Park, one of four national parks in South Florida. Ryan and I are here today to teach children how to explore, learn, and protect our national park treasures. Ryan and I are going to become junior park rangers.
Hi, Penny.
Hi. Hi, Ryan.
Welcome to Biscayne National Park.
My name is Liz. I'm one of the rangers that work here. In order to become junior rangers, there are four activities that you have to complete. Here's the junior ranger book. And it's filled with fun activities that will help you to learn and explore Biscayne National Park. We can do that by starting the map activity on the first page, and we can figure out where we are.
We're right there, right before the Florida Keys.
And just south of Miami. The park is 95% covered in water, so the best way to explore the park and to become junior rangers is to get out onto the water. And if you'd like, we can go out on a boat and take a closer look at Biscayne National Park.
Yes!
Awesome. Let's get going. What a great ride across Biscayne Bay. Welcome to Boca Cheetah Key. And this is where we are going to start learning and exploring so we can protect Biscayne National Park and everything that's in it. Here are some tools to help you get started on your journey.
Wow, what do we have?
Well, Penny, we have some binoculars.
Ah, that's good, right?
And the binoculars are to help you see things that are far away. And here's a magnifying glass that will help you see things that are close up. And then we also have a special glass bottom bucket that will help you see things that are in the water.
Hi.
Hi. Okay, I think we're ready. We have our three activities. We're gonna do our scavenger hunt, we're gonna explore the mangroves, and then we'll go on a magical trip to the coral reef. Okay, Ryan?
Cool.
Yeah, let's get started. Where should we start first?
Well, the top of the lighthouse has some fantastic views to see everything all around Biscayne National Park.
We can use our binoculars.
Yeah.
Okay. Shall we go?
Yeah, let's go.
Hey, Ryan, do you see under the water there? It looks like grass.
Yeah.
It's a little bit different from the grass at your house. It's special grass that can live in the salt water. And it's a really good place for different kinds of marine organisms to live. And all of Biscayne Bay, out as far as we can see, is covered in seagrass. Biscayne Bay is a nursery area for marine organisms. Ryan, we're looking for a sea grape tree. Got really big, thick leaves. Do you see anything like that?
Oh, yeah.
Awesome. Should we go take a look at it?
Could you tell us something about the sea grape leaves?
I sure can. They're really special leaves. If you want to take a close look at it and feel it, early pioneers who lived in Biscayne National Park before it became a national park would use sea grape leaves as paper.
Paper?
Shall we keep exploring?
Yes. That's crazy. He's walking with us. We are finding so many things.
You're doing great.
This is exciting. Oh, look! Look at all the fish. We can definitely mark fish off. We have found a lot.
Wow, look at all the mangroves around us. Do you have red mangroves on your scavenger hunt?
Yes.
Awesome. You can identify the red mangrove by the walking roots. It looks like the roots are walking out into the water. The roots are great. It tangles all up and makes it almost like a net. So it helps to protect the land from the sea, but also the sea from the land. They're very, very special trees that like to live in hot environments, like here in South Florida.
Hey, what else do you see down there, Ryan?
Oh, crab.
Very cool. Good
eye. We get to mark that off our list. We are getting somewhere. We're almost done. No.
Actually, mosquitoes are really important in the food chain. And I know a lot of people think they're a pest.
I think they are.
There are so many animals that actually eat mosquitoes. And so if we got rid of all the mosquitoes, and there'd be a lot of animals that didn't have any food.
Let's walk over to the water for our next activity. We need to have our life jackets on. It's time for our mangrove feeding frenzy. Let's find out about the mangroves before we actually go investigate them.
So we have mangroves all along the coastline of Biscayne National Park.
Look, those are black mangroves. They grow from the bottom up, and there's the red mangroves. See the difference?
Yeah.
Hermit crabs don't have their own shell. They have to borrow shells. They have to go looking for new shells.
Right, it's the same thing as the book says. He lives at the bottom of the mangroves. I want to look at him closely.
Ryan, the things that live here have to be super hardy because sometimes they're covered in water and sometimes they're totally exposed. So they have to be ready to adapt to any kind of environment. Very good, good eyes. Let's go find some deeper water.
Let's be careful not to walk on the sponges because they're keeping the water clean.
Very good eyes. Tulip snail.
And let's take a magic trip today to the Coral Reef and find all the wonderful things that live there. Biscayne National Park protects the northern part of the third largest coral reef in the world. Corals are made from small animals that are about the size of a pencil eraser called coral polyps. The coral polyps make a limestone cup which they sit in. They eat tiny plants and tiny animals that stick to their stinging tentacles. Thank you for a great day. Now we are ready to head back to be sworn in as official Junior Park Rangers.
I say your name.
Ryan.
And Penny.
Promise.
To protect and preserve.
To protect and preserve
the plants, animals, and history.
The plants, animals, and history.
Of Biscayne National Park.
And we'll continue to explore these national treasures.
These national treasures.
Congratulations.
You too can become a junior ranger. When you visit Biscayne National Park or any national park, ask the park ranger about the special activities that will help you become a junior ranger. Go online to www.nps.gov to learn more about a national park in your area.
As you can see, Biscayne National Park is a pretty good place. It is so great that it has been set aside for us. Now it is our turn to protect and preserve Biscayne so others can experience it.